Hey guys, and welcome to D-Plays. Today I'll be playing one of my favorite games on the Nintendo Entertainment System, and it also happens to be the most expensive game in my collection, Panic Restaurant. Walking along, fruit falling from the sky. And also a pumpkin.
I am Odove. I have taken your nice little restaurant.
The way the levels are set up, they're all based off of dishes in a meal, and the level screen is a nice little menu. It's pretty cool. Chickens, carrots. And somehow they're all carrying one coin. Not really sure how that works. Eaton is the name of the restaurant that Odove has, I guess, taken over. Candy heals, but I don't need any health. Shortest first stage ever, by the way. Ah, you son of a bitch. I usually try to do a no-death run, but honestly, I can probably count on one hand how many times that stupid pot has actually killed me. So it's not many. So I lost all my coins because I died, except for the 6 I got from beating the pan. At the end of each level, you have this slot machine thing. Cat here. You can skip it by pressing select. Jiggly flans. Some pizza wheels. The spoon is my favorite weapon. It's got the longest reach. You'll see later in the game, though, there are some areas that are better suited for the pan you start off with because it's kind of a downward swing. Catch the fish. Obviously, you don't want to catch the bombs or torpedoes or whatever they are. Want to be bullet bills. I think the highest I've gotten in that one is like 23, so you can get more. These onions that look surprisingly like Goombas. Those exploding apples can be kind of tricky. I like when Cookie jumps. Cookie's the name of the main character. I like when he jumps, how his mouth gets all wide.
Wow!
Somebody needs to call an electrician. Ugh, son of a bitch. Those faulty wires on the chandeliers. This is pretty cool. It basically gives you invincibility. get all dizzy and... I hate this fort, but for the sake of this playthrough, I'm gonna get it. I do like the angry eyebrows he has when he points on them, though. This fork is hard to aim. It's the worst weapon in the game, in my opinion. Playthrough, I'm gonna get these plates. Not my favorite weapon because with throwing them at an arc kind of limits the area that you can actually hit with them. And whenever you get a weapon power up, anytime you get hit, naturally you'll go back to your default pan. Deep cut mice? Or whatever they are. They look like mice, I don't know. I don't want that fork. Damn it! Yep. Just to get rid of the fork. Do what you gotta do sometimes, because that thing is awful. Give me the spoon! I do like the music. This game is very lighthearted, I guess. These toasters can be a pain. They're mortar toast. Take the egg. See, now I feel like the names of the two bonus stages, because there's only two, should be switched. I feel like this should be catch the egg, since you're catching the egg in a pan, and the other one should be take the fish, since you're using the extendo arm to kind of snatch him out of thin air. Similar to the other one, you don't want to catch the bombs, because then you'll lose. The minigame will be over. Bounce. Better. See, I think there's up here. No, it's down there. The best way to handle those guys is to take them out before they wake up and start shooting stuff at you. Spoon. know if you noticed earlier when I got one, but the lollipops will fill your health up and give you an extra heart, but since I have the max of 4, it just filled up. No. That boss is weird. Like, sometimes he'll pass right through you, and sometimes he'll hit you. I'm not sure if you only take damage from the falling shrimp, or if you also take damage from the, I guess, the soup or whatever it is inside of him splashing from side to side as he moves. I'm not really sure. Let's see if I can get some health filled up here. It helps to, I guess, memorize where all the shish kebabs are. I don't want that plate. There's chicken legs. The clouds cannot be killed. Just kind of have to avoid them. This is one of my favorite things about the game. The game as a whole is super charming. But that extra mile that went into making the spikes dinner knives, I think that's really cool. Really speaks to the restaurant style theme that they were going for, more so than a lot of the other things. Because you know you have your chains, sure, and you know all that stuff's supposed to be like silverware type. But damn it, sometimes they do that. Sometimes they disappear, and sometimes they'll come back. Seems completely random. But yeah. And spikes are an instant kill, by the way, in this game. Do not want that fork down there, so I do. Oh, damn it. I'm paying attention. I like how his mustache flops up and down when he walks. It's pretty funny. I lost my spoon. Is he, like, making an omelet or something, or, I mean, because if so, it's going to have a bunch of eggshell in it, and cut people's mouths all up. But you still can't take out those clouds, and that one-up is a total trap, because there's no way to get it without dying. Steak knives. Don't need that candy. Cheeseburger. As you can see, I'm not doing very well, but no. As you can see, a lot of the bosses have these set patterns. Once you learn those, they're pretty easy to take down. This is by far, this is not my best, one. Give me my health back. I feel like this level should be called Fish, because it's in the freezer, and you think, you know, frozen fish, and the other level with it being kind of a barbecue, and you fight that cheeseburger, or hamburger at the end. I feel like that one should be meat, but whatever. Angry Fork. Fork you. Frying pan is the best weapon for this area because of the slopes. That air will freeze you. Hopefully, I will not have to showcase that. Yeah, that air is fine. Go figure. This is a tough area because if you get hit by any of those rocket popsicles, they will, when you get hit, you bounce. And if you hit those, if you get hit by those, they'll bounce you right up into those spikes and it'll be an instant kill or an instant death, whatever. So you want to avoid them at all costs. From memorization, knowing those popsicles are gonna come up. I've gotten that one up before, but 9 times out of 10, I'd rather not risk it. I think the one time I got it, I just made a point to go for it just to say that I got it. I got it. I like how he's just all of a sudden in the middle of, like, the sea, by an ocean or whatever. So he needs to run the defrost in this here freezer. I guess the other popsicles were, like, mint flavored, and those are orange or something. I don't know. Am I reading too much into this? Yeah, full health. I don't need to go for that. This boss, sometimes I do well in this boss, sometimes not as well. This is gonna be a not as well fight, I believe. Fantastic. Shit. Sometimes they just continuously respawn. It's really hard to work your way through those waterfall areas sometimes. I want that spoon. I got that spoon. Your face. I'm not even gonna worry with that guy. Alright, here we go. Slow down. Shoot those French fries at you. You can hit them back. Obviously, they won't hit them, but it's a good defense. Speed training. Can you tell I've done this before? God, this freaking fish! I want that candy, please. These tough jumps. No! That jump has killed many a no-death run for me in the past. You gotta be real precise about jumping right at the edge of the platform. Got it. What are these pumpkins so happy about anyway? I want that plate. Now see, the tricky thing with the plates is, since they are destroyed when you hit the wall with them, they are no good in that situation because you can't shoot through the wall, but you know, they can, the enemies. So the spoon is really, really good to have there so you can, you know, provide some defense. just out of range as far as being able to hit it with your spoon. As far as it's just slightly lower than where your swing goes.
Well, I'll call me your lucky guy, but your luck has just run out. Bye!
Jerk. Busted old pan. Looks more like a teacup than anything.
Yeah, you can't catch up to me with a broken down pan like that.
That's what I feel like he sounds like in my head. Okay. Pop that balloon. I one-shot it. Yes, I can. Alright. Yeah. Once he gets over to the right side again, his balloon will re-inflate. So it's, you kind of have to do it in one shot, or you'll have to start over. Even from that distance, I feel like he would have shattered his tailbone and, you know, been seriously injured, but whatever. The end. That's Panic Restaurant. It's not a long game, but it's super fun for what it is. I don't typically speedrun, but I have attempted to speedrun this one, and my best time was 20 minutes and 2 seconds. I was actually really disappointed that I didn't break that 20 minute mark. I believe people have done it in like 13 minutes or less, which is pretty amazing. It's not difficult, but like you'd be hard-pressed to find another game with as much charm oozing out of it than Panic Restaurant. Thanks for watching, guys, and we'll do this again sometime real soon. Have a good night.